Okay, I think I might have fixed the lean problem with this thing, with this 850. It was last time we used it, it was leaning out. I got it running and squirted a bit of the old that stuff in there around the base of the carburetor, which cut it off pretty much straight away, and then pulled it apart, and sure enough, there's your problem. So done that, made up a new gasket and put it together, and it appears a lot better. I do have these pretty tight, I must admit. I wouldn't want to get them too much tighter. And also I checked the main seal underneath here, pulled all that off, and that's fine. I didn't check this side of it because it's a bit of a pain in the ass to check that, pull the flywheel off, etc. So hopefully that's fine. I'm going to take it down to the paddock and throw it into some wood and see how it goes. I'll take that 288 hybrid back in there as well, and I can probably give them a good run against them. I will have to retune this because the high and low jet needles are actually that length. That's the end of them right there. So that's how long they are, and you can get it up to the side, and I just pull them out, and then you can lift this off. It makes life a lot easier. Don't want to damage the linkages in here, because everything's, it's a 40-year-old chainsaw at the end of the day. But I'll stop blathering and put it all back together, and we'll get stuck in. Rightio, Tim. We'll get this 181. I'll show you that running. That's the decomp button. As you can see, I didn't get the bloody hole square. Well, centered, I should say, which is just will annoy me forever. Anyway, could be worse. I'll throw that into the timber. I've just put a bigger, I've got the same size bar and chain on these two, and they're about the same sharpness and the same wear. Yeah, this thing goes, mate, so if you find another one, sing out, and we'll put a 288 top end on it.
slow. These things are not so slow.
Tea's turned up. Excellent. Right, this one here is a 1983-61 Husqvarna. I've had this chainsaw for a long time. It wasn't very old, and I didn't buy it new, but it was... it wasn't very old when I bought this thing, and I've done absolutely nothing to it. I mean nothing. All I've done is starter cord, probably a new spark plug, I couldn't be too sure about that, and I've adjusted the idle. That's it. I haven't touched the carburetor or anything. It's probably why it goes so well, because I haven't frigged around with it. But I'll give this one a run. This hasn't been run for ages, so see how she goes. Is it turned on? Maybe. Up here. How's that? Is that better? Maybe not. Of course I'll be able to edit all this stuff out, you know, which I won't. Rightio, Tim, this is a 288, well 18, you know, as I said, with the decomp in it. It's got the 288 top end on it. I hope you can hear me over the noise of that bloody thing. And a modified muffler. It's very noisy. But by jingle, she goes. Rightio, we'll dig that one in. That's the only thing with a sore Tim. She likes a drink. Sorry that. Trip hazards here. Yeah, so I guess out of the two saws between the 181 hybrid and the Mac 850, the 181's got the power. But it's not really apples for apples, is it? I mean, this is a brand new top end, and that thing is a knot. Even though the Mac is actually in good nick. It's no scores, and it has pretty good compression, but it's not the same as this. But then again, you know, this has got a pretty lousy squish, so it hasn't got the best of compression anyway. But as you can see, it revs like buggery, and it leaks oil out of the cap. So there's another job. Anyway, I'll load up and get back. But I'll just sort of let you have a look at that Husky tin. Yeah, works well. Okay, anyway, enough of my blathering. Bit of an interesting side note, Timmy. This Pioneer 620 is 23 pound, about 11 kgs. And the 81, bloody hell, hang on. That is near as damn it to 20 pound, or around about 9 kgs. And this is the interesting one, is the 61, because it feels just as bloody near as heavy. It's 2 pounds lighter. Wow. Pound and a half, really. But it only has a 16 inch baron at this thing, so it's not as well balanced. It actually feels, and because the handle's a bit thinner, it actually feels a bit heavier too. I don't know about your 268, how that feels. I'll just try this thing here. And the 850, McCulloch is 20 pound, 21 pound, slightly heavier than the 181, just by not much in it, you know, to be honest. So heaviest, that one, and the 61 is, if you put the same bar and chain on the 61 as the 81, I reckon they'd be the same weight. I must actually just, well, I can't be bothered, but yeah, they're quite heavy, those bloody things, actually, for what they are. Anyway, that'll do.